With Hall of Famer Grant Hill and Brent Berry, this is Brian Anderson. We'll be hearing from Allie LaForce from the sideline. And a chance here to check out some stats for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And by looking at his true shooting percentage over the last five games, you can see how much he's paying attention to his shot selection, and it's showing.
Now let's take a look at the Rockets' opening lineup. Van Vliet and Green man the backcourt. Smith plays the four with Şengün at the five. And it's Brooks in at the three. And for Milwaukee, Giannis and Lopez together down low. Filling out the wings, it's Beasley and Middleton. And it's Lillard in at the one spot. Well, Grant, it's the time of year where teams are starting to find their identity and looking forward to the coming months.
Yeah, you know, you're through the initial grind, and it's onward and upward from here. But teams are still figuring out who the contenders and pretenders might be. But nobody's hopes are completely tarnished just yet.
Tip-off goes to Milwaukee. From the wing, and he buries his first look.
There is this old-school feel about Dame's game. Even though he utilizes the three, he'll get to the mid-range and bury those.
Lillard against Van Vliet. Pass to Brooks. Now here's Smith. Shot clock at five. Fires the three. Rebounded by Lopez. And it's Lillard with a ball for the Bucks. Well, Grant, how do the Bucks put the pieces back together and make a run at another title?
Well, the hope is this new coaching staff will unlock some new wrinkles and find ways to keep their offense from stalling in the clutch.
Brooks against Middleton. Brooks drives in, and it's good. Fought through contact, hit the shot, and will go to the line.
One shot.
To respect Brooks' approach to the game. He's always looking for little ways to improve and wants every year to be his best.
Now here's Lillard, coming in off 21 points in his last outing. Misses the three. Smith passes to Green. Pass to Brooks. Late clock, Houston's got to hurry. The three, Smith. Giannis Antetokounmpo grabs the board. The Bucks have gone 2 of 3 from the floor. Beasley with it. Antetokounmpo inside, guarded by Van Vliet. And Giannis throws it down.
I don't know how many defenders are stopping Giannis when he's up like that.
For Houston, they've gone 1 for 3 so far. Pass to Şengün. Here's Green. On the wing, Brooks. Middleton covering. Brooks, the pass to Green. Smith with a screen on Beasley. And that one's good. Green.
Yeah, and Green has tons of confidence in his three-point shot. And it was on display right there as he knocked it down.
Lillard against Van Vliet. Takes a three, and it's Lillard with the three. Lillard's got five.
Man, he's bringing the energy, the efficiency. I love what he's doing offensively.
Kind of amazing that Lillard wasn't a big-time prospect at a high school, Brent.
Well, size had a lot to do with that, B.A., and then Damian Lillard, it's hard to scout Will. and he certainly has loads of that. Not many guys have a feel for the game like Dame does.
So it's Milwaukee now, after the Rockets picked up a basket a moment ago. Smith against Antetokounmpo. And they double up Antetokounmpo. Three-pointer is up. Middleton, good. And Antetokounmpo gets the assist.
Well, he's accurate from behind the arc, and there's a reason why Chris Middleton takes a good amount of three-pointers.
And so it's Green who brings up the ball for the Rockets. Trailing by four, they come into this one having outplayed the Grizzlies last time.
Yeah, and that one came down to their rebounding. There was a big gap between the two teams there.
Yeah, I'm not sure if their last game was a basketball game or a wrestling match, the way they went about it. Just so physical and dominated there.
And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Lillard against Van Vliet. Pass to Middleton. Brooks with the rebound. For Houston, they've gone 4 of 6 in the first quarter. Green in the post, working on Lopez.
Well, that's out of there. Not a high riser, but Lopez using his frame. A smart block, if you will.
Here's Lillard. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up. And Grant, the Rockets opening up the pocketbooks. Brought in several vets over the summer.
Yeah, I mean, Van Vliet and Brooks are the big names. I mean, they wanted to spend to get leaders to help their young core. We'll see how it mixes, but they feel now it's the time to make their move.
Free throw good, Lillard. Well, Grant, the Rockets finished at the bottom of the Western Conference for three straight seasons and got some high draft picks as a result.
And B.A., no one likes losing, but Houston has to be happy with the talented young prospects they've been able to select. It'll be interesting to watch their growth as individuals and as a team.
Both shots good from the strike. Well, Brent, one area of the floor where the Bucks really shine is on defense.
Yeah, no question. This defense is one that just smothers you, and if you're not ready for it, well, they could come at you defensively in waves. They don't let you rebound. They pressure shooters, and they're going to make you work for every bucket.
Van Vliet misses.
Yeah, better than giving up the layup. You want to go in there and use the hard foul. They did it there. That's aggressive attitude defensively.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
Tate. The Rockets with another miss. Milwaukee in the lead. Middleton with it. Tate picks him up defensively. 8-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Shoots from the right block. And that one's good. Middleton. Middleton's got his second bucket of the night.
Their offense looking like a well-oiled machine.
We've got 22 seconds left in the first quarter. Now here's Van Vliet. In his last outing, he had 11 points. Let's it fly. That one doesn't drop.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
And so it's Milwaukee leading by 6 as we wrap up the quarter. Defense is setting the tone. All right, stick around. We'll be right back after this. If you're just joining us, we played through one quarter in this one. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Bucks, guys.
They are looking engaged so far, especially on offense.
Well, if they wanted to start well, this would be it. They seized momentum right away, and they just didn't let it go in that quarter.
Here's Thompson, yet to see a basket. So the Rockets 5 now. Tari Eason is out there with Alperen Şengün. Then it's Thompson, then it's Aaron Holiday, and it's Tate in at the 3. Eason, a screen on Payne. Here's Thompson. Drops it in from 14 feet away. Thompson's got his first 2 points of the night, and the NBA doing what they could to get rid of the take foul recently. Grant, it seems like a success.
Absolutely. It's been a huge success. Fast breaks feel fast again, and penalizing take fouls has made the game much, much better. He's as surprised as we are. Most nights, that bucket is automatic.
Şengün, a screen on Payne. Outside Tate. Back to Eason. Pass to Thompson. Oh, he tries a three. And Beauchamp pulls it down. Here's Milwaukee. They lead by four. Fresh off a win against the Pacers.
Hey, guys, can we show some love to the defense in that game? They were relentless. They were dominant. It was just a great performance overall.
Yeah, last game was pretty impressive stuff on that end of the floor, just getting up near shooters and blocking as many shots as they did.
Tate, a screen on Payne. Here's Thompson, off target at the rim. And so it's Milwaukee with it. They lead by six. That's their biggest margin. They're getting their first look of the season at the Rockets in this one.
Last year, they battled to a stalemate, winning one game apiece.
Yeah, even when it comes to matchups where it looks like one side should be the clear favorite, those brief two-game series often end 1-1. Yeah, the screen is the key to that whole sequence right there. No way he's letting anybody power their way through him on that pick.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Bucks.
Well, you got to be impressed with how selfless they've been so far. Their passing has been simply outstanding.
Well, I want to add also the damage that has been done on the inside. It's a lot of rubble in there, but they're continuing to go right at the defense.
And so Thompson will bring it up for Houston. 9-point game. At the conclusion of this one, they're off to Memphis, where they'll face the Grizzlies. That'll be the second of four games total on the road for them. Green. The Rockets with another miss. For Milwaukee, they've got two of three shots to go in the second. Well, Brent, when you talk about Giannis Antetokounmpo, still one of the league's elite players.
Unbelievable, B.A., the way he started off his career. You felt like there was an end to his improvement. That hasn't been the case. Just a strong work ethic, a desire to compete every day that he's in the gym, and the guy keeps getting better. That's scary.
Their ball movement on this run has been tremendous. It's led to a lot of good, clean, open looks.
Beasley against Green. Pass to Şengün. Lays it up and banks it in.
Yeah, here's a list of things I don't want to do, and right at the top is guard that guy.
Middleton looking around. Now here's Antetokounmpo, defended by Eason, and they double up Antetokounmpo. Beasley for three. No good that time. The Rockets shooting only 40% from the floor in this game. Pass to Thompson. Now Green. Şengün finds Green. Outside Eason. Brooks right side. Shot clock at six. Here's Thompson. Giannis Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Antetokounmpo has got his fourth rebound in this one.
His touch has left him in this quarter. Nowhere close to the kind of output they need from him.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Ali LaForce.
Well, Damian Lillard embraces the big moments. He said, quote, I don't know why, I just do it. It's internal. I'm always talking to myself like, quote, I have to find a way. This is an opportunity to rise and to come up big. You've got to get it going. It's a real thing. You just demand that something extra of yourself. Brian?
Thank you, Allie. Dame time is very real. Timeout call. Timeout. Milwaukee.
And things are always changing throughout a game. Teams have to adjust on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in and recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team.
And the Bucks with some changes. Lopez comes in for Portis. And Lillard subbed in for Payne. Smith, he's checked in for the Rockets. Fred VanVleet comes in for Thompson. .105 left in the second period. Lillard passes to Middleton. Beasley outside. Antetokounmpo for three. And again, it's the Bucks missing. The Rockets have gone 3 for 7 here in the second quarter. VanVleet against Lillard. From 9 feet out, rejected by Lopez. And so it looks like the Rockets will retain possession here. .41 seconds left to play in the second quarter. Brooks, the pass to Green. 5 on the clock. Şengün, the screen. Launches a three.
Yeah, he was really shooting the ball well at the start, but he's somehow getting less and less consistent.
Pass to Middleton. Lopez with it. Out to Beasley to stop the drought. And he's in the books. Now 1 for 2.
Fundamental play there from Lopez, spotting the open man and then sending him the ball.
VanVleet right side. Green for three. And at the buzzer, counted.
Just textbook. Kept his cool and waited for his shot.
That's exactly how you want to close out the quarter, too, with some confidence.
And so it's the Milwaukee Bucks, up by a healthy 8 points at the end of the period. Great shot selection right now, keeping the game simple and getting high percentage looks. Back to the game after this break.
Welcome to halftime, and after two quarters played, some ground to make up for the Houston Rockets.
Well, they aren't getting a hand up on the shooters, and the numbers show it, Shaq. Guys are too good in this league to give them easy looks. You're just digging your own grave.
Well, excuse me, Jack, giving the tough love. Bravo, bravo.
And changing gears now, looks like we've got some great interactions on social media. And we have a question from the epic bearded one for the panel. When was the last time you wore spandex, Shaq?
Well, epic bearded face. Thanks for the question. Believe it or not, I'm wearing spandex right now.
What? Like, under your suit? Wow. You think you know someone.
Don't knock it, Ernie. You should forget that suit and just wear spandex. I have them on as well.
Thanks, as always, for watching. Let's head back to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the second half.
And if you just join it in, one half is in the books. One half to go. Nice game. Great performance by Jalen Green.
Can they come up with an answer for him coming out of the half? They have to change something defensively.
Yeah, just way too easy out there, and I'm sure Coach is going to make that a priority at halftime.
At small and power forward, it'll be Middleton and Giannis. Malik Beasley is out there with Damian Lillard, and it's Lopez in at the five. That's the group for Milwaukee right now.
And they've just built this lead by attacking the boards.
Grant, your first year in the league, 1995, the Houston Rockets were NBA champs.
Oh, B.A., I mean, Hakeem the Dream made facing that team a nightmare. He was everywhere defensively, long and quick on his feet. That 95 Houston team was incredible.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, Allie LaForce.
Hey, Brian. Well, everybody knows that Giannis Antetokounmpo is not just one of the best bigs in the league, but one of the best teammates all the way around. People say about him, he does everything. His teammates say he deals with guys, takes good care of them, makes sure they're healthy from top to bottom. He's the ultimate leader.
Special talent, Allie, and a special person. Thanks for that.
Such a reliable mid-range shooter. Brooks doesn't hesitate when he sees an opportunity to rise up from there.
Free throw line jumper. Oh, Lillard just owning the paint.
And he's going to nail these if you give him the space. That's just soft D.
Well, defense also looking defeated. The lack of hustle is driving the coaching staff a little bit batty right now.
Rejected by Antetokounmpo.
Anticipation and length makes Giannis a great shot blocker.
And you got to be in awe of incredible defensive efforts like this.
Yeah, good offense comes from great defense. This lead is only getting stronger with plays like that.
Milwaukee on D. Smith passes to Brooks. Up and in from the low block. Brooks has got his third basket on the night right there.
And give Brooks credit. I mean, the defense put up a stiff challenge, and in the end, he gets the better of the matchup with great offense.
Beasley outside, launches it, and the box hit again from deep.
Excellent execution coming out of the break. They've taken three shots and made three shots.
The Rockets have gotten two of four shots to go since the break. Up top, Şengün. And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Green, money from deep.
Oh, my. I mean, Green is ready for a duel at the arc. I mean, he's always an eager three-point shooter.
Here's Lillard. Pass to Middleton. Over Brooks. And Middleton gets it to go on the assist by Lillard. Middleton's got 7 points.
Fading away, he buries that one in traffic. Takes great body control to make that one go.
And Brooks has got the ball here for the Rockets. He's got 9. You know, when you look at Chris Middleton, Brent, he's been a competitor every way you slice it.
No doubt worked himself into a multiple-time All-Star in the Eastern Conference and one of the most consistent small forwards in the league. Also an NBA champ. I just hope his health can hold out, B.A.
Now here's Smith, still without a bucket. Brooks a screen on Lopez. Van Vliet, the pass to Şengün. Over on Antetokounmpo. Şengün, no good.
And even though he couldn't send the shot back at him, he certainly altered it.
Yeah, that's the kind of energy that you want to see on every possession throughout the game.
Here's Lillard. It's rebounded by Şengün.
You won't see him miss that one too many times.
Yeah, that happens. Important thing is for players, just don't beat yourself up and make a miss like that cost you another play.
Now here's Brooks. 7 points in the game. And there's the whistle. The illegal screen is the call.
You're not going to fool the officials too often on an illegal screen.
Yeah, everybody saw that one. That was pretty blatant there.
Beauchamp, he's checked in for Beasley. Eason's checked in for the Rockets. 1:37 left in the third. Lopez, the screen on Brooks. And that one's good. Middleton. Middleton's got 4 points in the quarter.
Not much else the D can do against something like that. Chris Middleton so fast in getting that shot off.
The Rockets have gotten 3 of 6 shots to fall so far in the third. Outside, Green. The rebound by the Bucks. Antetokounmpo has got 6 rebounds now in the game. Pass to Lopez. Brooks against Middleton. And here's Lillard. Just 5 to shoot. There's the 3. Rockets with a rebound.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. He just missed it.
Here's Van Vliet. And he can't stop the drought. Another miss.
And this feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
Here's Beauchamp. 12-point lead, their biggest of the game. Middleton from the outside. Smith with the rebound. Smith's got 4 rebounds in the game. Pass to Van Vliet. Smith with a screen on Lillard. Here's Van Vliet. For 3, Smith.
And Lopez doing what he can to just be disruptive out there, distracting shooters.
And so it's Milwaukee, now holding a 12-point lead at quarter's end. Building this lead up in large part because of how well they're shooting it. Time for a quick break, then back to the action. And let's take this opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
This is the definition of team chemistry. I love to see this kind of communication and connection between teammates leading to the perfect pass.
The coaches talk about it all the time, but to be able to play with that kind of feel, nice play, collaborating, improvising, and organic.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same for the first 3 quarters. So the Houston Five right now. They've got Thompson, Alperen Şengün out there with Jeff Green. Then there's Jayshon Tate, and it's Holiday in at the shooting guard position. Now here's Connaughton, back to Antetokounmpo. Over Green. And it's Antetokounmpo with the miss.
Well, that's the only way to take him out of his comfort zone from that range. Get right up in the jersey, force him off the spot.
Here's Portis. And that one's in. Nice feed on the play. And the Bucks lead by 14.
Well, now they're demoralized, guys. A careless play to turn it over and then slow to get back on defense.
Thompson against Payne. Pass to Şengün. Back to Thompson. Outside Holiday. And here is Şengün, defended by Portis. Connaughton against Şengün. It's not going to go for him.
And it's amazing. Their slim advantage on the board seems a lot larger than it is.
Portis finds Antetokounmpo. Now here's Payne. Connaughton outside. To the right side. And they double up Antetokounmpo. The Bucks need to get up a shot here. Here's Beasley. From out on the wing, he knocks it down.
and just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now trying to put this one away.
And a little over a minute and a half gone by in the fourth. Timeout call.
Timeout,
Houston.
Timeout. You know, there's so much to like about Connaughton's game. He brings a lot to the table, especially from deep.
Well, I love the fact that Pat just knows himself. He's out there to make hustle plays, timely shots, get a key offensive rebound that helps the team maintain possession. What a tremendous role player for this squad.
And some changes here for the Bucks. Lopez, he's checked in for Portis. Chris Middleton comes in for Connaughton. And Damian Lillard subbed in for Payne. And the Rockets will go for a different look here. Smith, he's checked in for Green. Brooks comes in for Tate. Jalen Green, he's checked in for Holiday. And Fred VanVleet is subbed in for Thompson. Smith passes to Brooks. Outside, Green. To the paint. Here's VanVleet. Smith outside. Just four to shoot. What a terrific move that is.
That's a confidence builder for Smith Jr., proving he can score through contact.
And here's Antetokounmpo. He'll bring it up for Milwaukee. A great fourth quarter. Just give it up 2 points. Middleton from the outside. It's rebounded by Houston.
And that's a strong closeout defensively. Great effort to deter the shot.
VanVleet against Lillard. Smith with a screen on Lillard. Here's VanVleet. Lillard pulls down the board. The Bucks have gotten half of their attempts to fall in the fourth. 2 for 4 now. Pass to Antetokounmpo. Green against Beasley. 6 on the shot clock. The 3. And it's Lillard. That time on the assist by Lopez. And the Bucks lead by 17. For Houston, they've gotten just one shot to fall out of 3 attempts in the fourth. VanVleet on the wing, defended by Lillard. VanVleet against Lillard. Pass to Şengün. Outside, Green for 3. Green with a 3. That's how you respond.
These teams are finding the range, showing a lot of confidence.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
Timeout called. Milwaukee. They're ahead by 14. A minute 35 left in the fourth. A minute 35 left in the fourth quarter. Houston has gone 4 of 9 so far from the perimeter. Smith passes to Van Vliet. Beasley against Green. Picked by Smith. Shoots a fadeaway. Giannis with the rebound. Antetokounmpo has got rebound number 8 now. Beasley outside. Well, from broadcasting to team ownership, heading USA Basketball, Grant, what drives you to do so much these days?
Well, B.A., I'm an active guy, and I had a great playing career. But the things I wasn't able to do because of the injury, I think, left me even more motivated to excel and try new things in this next chapter of my life.
Now here's Van Vliet. Out to the wing for three. Smith gets the three to fall.
Oh, showing his competitive streak. Smith really wanted to answer them.
41 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Middleton outside. Out to the right wing. And they double up on it to Kumpo. Beasley misses from close range. And Brooks has got the ball here for the Rockets. They trail by 14. Here's Smith. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line. They pin that one on Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And you talk about a guy who has all the tools and a great work ethic too. Jabari Smith. Wow.
That one's off.
And the number 3 pick in the 2022 NBA draft, Smith Jr.'s ceiling is considered to be very high.
Good on the second one. 20 seconds left in the fourth quarter. No need to shoot. This one is done.
Yes, they've got to be happy with tonight's effort.
Thompson against Green. So this one belongs to the Bucks. A clean win, and one where they clearly showed better energy.
Yes, so true. They put on a show here at home. And I really think they had that extra swagger and confidence, too.
All right, Allie's ready to go. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Dame, for those of us watching, what does it feel like to be in a shooting groove like you were in tonight?
It feels like a workout. You know, when I'm doing my summertime workouts, even after practice sometimes, I'm just trying to get hot, you know, trying to get that rhythm. And that's what it feels like, you know, when you hold yourself to that standard of just making shots, being consistent at it and just getting hot, you know, and that's kind of what it felt like.
I can guarantee you none of our workouts feel like that. But thanks for the show tonight, Dame.
Thanks, Allie. Great interview once again. And that about wraps it up. For Allie LaForce, Grant Hill, and Brent Berry, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching tonight's game. Now it's time for the New Balance Player of the Game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.